So many people have asked me, how did this Texas journalist come to write about Australia's greatest race? And I'll tell you why. Because it's the best story I've ever encountered. Not only is it the best story that I've ever encountered, but the people that I've talked to who recommend, who extol, who just talk about it endlessly, starting with the first person that told me about it, America's greatest polo player, Memo Gracita. Now, Memo's played polo as a 10-goaler for 20 years. It's an unbelievable achievement. He's been a top equestrian his entire career, and he was playing in Melbourne the weeks of the Melbourne Cup Carnival. He got to go on Cup Day, and this professional witnessed a sporting achievement that sent him back to the States, and the next month he collared me and he said, you have to write this story. His wife said, you have to write this story. You will never see a stadium with 120 some odd thousand people shrieking, screaming, crying, clutching strangers for the moment of this great achievement. And that's starting just with Memo and Mimi. When you go beyond that, when I called up Simon Windsor and told him what I was onto, and he started to explore it more deeply, he just came back and said, Eric, this is not a book. This is a movie. And for a storyteller of Simon's caliber, I mean, I know people who have named their children for characters in Simon's movies. And for a storyteller of Simon's caliber to say that is, again, reinforcing something that was already becoming apparent to me. If you flip all the way through my book and get to the very last page in the acknowledgments, the last person I thank is Des Gleason. 30-some-odd years as a steward, and as we all know, the chief steward, the last portion of his career. And how does he describe Damien's achievement? As the most emotion-filled moment of his career. He said there was not a dry eye in the steward's room when Damien came in after crossing the finish line. That's one side of why I know I had to write this story. The other side came from Damien himself. And it's something that I've really taken away from my experience with him. We were in Port Melbourne, and we were talking about the end of the 2002 flat season, and he was trying to get on Vinnie Rowe, obviously Europe's champion stayer. The other alternative was Media Puzzle, a non-winner in its last 8 outings. More importantly, in its last 3 outings before coming to Australia, it had finished dead last in 2 of those races, 8th out of 8 and 13th out of 13. And I said, well, when you didn't get Vinnie Rowe, what did you think about, you know, landing, you know, what did you think about Dermot's decision? And Damien has not just great professional experience, but he has a pedigree that goes so deep in the thoroughbred tradition. I mean, his grandfather, a jockey, his father, a jockey, his brother, a jockey. He's been a jockey since he's been a teenager. And what did he tell me? He said, you've got to understand, jockeys like myself, jockeys like Pat Smullen, we live to find a champion. We live to find a great horse that we can partner with and win the great races with and go the distance with and end up in the history books next to. And he said, quite frankly, Vinnie Rowe is Pat Smullen's champion. There's no way I could cut in line and get on board that ride. And that's the way I think of the Cup. This is my champion.